और इस सेशन में दो स्पीकर्स आपको मुखातिब करेंगे. सबसे पहले प्रोफेसर हरगोपाल साहब आपको मुखातिब करेंगे और उसके बाद प्रोफेसर आई रामब्रह्मम साहब आपको मुखातिब करेंगे. मैं सबसे पहले हमारे हरदिल अजीज़ प्रोफेसर, जिनको मैं गुरु मानता हूँ, एक बात और मैं यहाँ कह दूँ, उनका शागिर्द कहलाना भी एक खुशकिस्मती है, वैसी शख्सियत है. तो उनको मैं ज़हमत ख़िताब देता हूँ, वो आपको मुखातिब करेंगे बजट एंड सोशल जस्टिस. और अब उनकी तकरीर, अब उनकी मर्ज़ी, क्योंकि वो चाहे अंग्रेज़ी में दें या फिर कुछ दरमियान में उर्दू वगैरह का इस्तेमाल करें, उनकी अपनी मर्ज़ी है. प्रोफेसर हरगोपाल साहब,
अब ऐसा है कि मैं तो थोड़ा बाइलिंगुअल मेथड यूज़ करूँगा. एक बार मैं ओल्ड सिटी गया था, जब मेरे को मालूम हुआ कि मैं थोड़ा उर्दू में भी बात कर सकता हूँ. जब तक मैं कभी लेक्चर उर्दू में नहीं दिया, मगर सब लोग उर्दू वाले थे, वो इंग्लिश तो नहीं समझते थे. तो आपने बोले कि आप थोड़ा हिंदी में बात करिए, तो मैं बोला हमारे हिंदी का तो वर्ब और जेंडर का प्रॉब्लम है. अब तो सब लोग हंसेंगे, तो फिर भी बोले साहब आप थोड़ा कोशिश करें. बिकॉज माई फादर यूज टू स्पीक वेरी चेस्ट उर्दू, ही वॉज ए एंड दैट्स हाउ वाट एवर लिटिल आई पिकड अप फ्रॉम माई फादर. एंड इन माई विलेज वी हैव अबाउट 1/5 पॉपुलेशन, मुस्लिम पॉपुलेशन, सो वी हैड that childhood acquaintance with Urdu, very intense. Just you know, as an introductory remark, that my village, as far as Urdu and you know Muslims are concerned, is a historical village, because Turabaz Khan, after he attacked the British resident in 1857, First War of Independence, he took shelter in my village. And then he was caught there, and he was publicly hanged before Koti Women's College, you know. And recently, myself, my wife, we gave from our savings a huge money to a library. Our village didn't have a library, and we have named our library as Turabaz Khan Memorial Library, because after he was caught, the British located the first school, the first police station, first school and first post office in my village, in my entire district. My school is one of the oldest schools in Mahbubnagar, because Turabaz Khan took shelter there, and British thought that this village has some revolutionary potential. And therefore, now see, this whole background is, I'm just sharing, because this village is about 77. Furkhan Sahib to chale ja rahe hain, so I would have taken him to my village so that he can see a village in a most backward district. अब जब हम बजट के बारे में बात करते हैं, फुरखान साहब तो एक बात बताए कि बजट को डिफरेंट एंगल से देख सकते हैं आप. उसको एक हिस्टोरिकल डॉक्यूमेंट के जैसा देख सकते हैं, एक टेक्निकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट, एक इकोनॉमिक इंस्ट्रूमेंट, उसको मार्केट लॉजिक से देख सकते हैं, सोशल लॉजिक से देख सकते हैं. यू कैन लुक एट बजट फ्रॉम डिफरेंट एंगल्स, फ्रॉम एन आइडियोलॉजिकल एंगल. अब फुरखान साहब तो प्लानिंग कमीशन में है, वो तो बहुत बैलेंस्ड पोजीशन ली है. कि बैलेंस पोजीशन ये है कि अब आइडियोलॉजिकली बजट इज स्लाइटली राइट ऑफ द सेंटर, राइट. इन द लास्ट 5 years ऑफ द फर्स्ट फेज ऑफ द यूपीए गवर्नमेंट, इट वॉज स्लाइटली लेफ्ट ऑफ द सेंटर. नाउ द बजट इज शिफ्टिंग फ्रॉम द राइट टू द सेंटर. तो हमारा तो फार लेफ्ट है, नॉट ओनली लेफ्ट ऑफ द सेंटर, हम तो बहुत लेफ्ट का थोड़ा दूर ना, बहुत. इसीलिए कि बजट को जब हम देखते हैं कि बजट का मकसद क्या होते हैं, उसका पर्पस क्या होते हैं, उसका फिलॉसफी क्या होती है. तो क्यों भाई, जब यूनिवर्सिटी में जब सेमिनार होते हैं, तो यूनिवर्सिटी का फंक्शन है कि रेस फंडामेंटल क्वेश्चंस, रेस मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस. एंड व्हेन यू लुक एट बजट, लॉन्ग बैक आई यूज टू टीच फाइनेंशियल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड यू नो दिस पब्लिक फाइनेंस in Kakatiya University, where I used to teach budget as an instrument of social change. Those were the days when budget was looked upon not as a mere technical instrument in terms of allocating the resources of a government in a particular year, but budget as an instrument of social change. Now, what is the type of social change that you are looking at, and how the budget can achieve this type of object? जब आप इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन को देखते हैं कि अगर आर्टिकल 38, 39 पढ़े, तो आर्टिकल 38-39 में ये लिखे हैं कि ये जो डेवलपमेंट होगा इंडिया में, ये प्रॉमिस ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, क्या ऐसा होगा कि जो डिस्पैरिटीज है बिटवीन रिच एंड पुअर और धनवान और गरीब के बीच में जो तो जो बड़ा गल्फ है, ये ऐसा हम डेवलपमेंट मॉडल बिल्ड करेंगे कि ये जो डिस्पैरिटी है ये कम होगा. द वेल्थ ऑफ द नेशन शैल बी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड इन सच ए मैनर दैट ऑल द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया विल हैव एक्सेस टू द वेल्थ ऑफ द नेशन. तो एक मकसद ये होता है बजट का और इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसी का कि एक मुल्क में जो डिस्पैरिटीज है, ये गरीब और अमीर का जो बीच में ये जो है इसको कम करना. एक दिस इज आई एम सेइंग फ्रॉम द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया. नाउ वो डायरेक्शन में अगर देखें तो 1950s बजट, ये वन गोज बैक, अब 1950s और 60s में इनकम टैक्स जो डायरेक्ट टैक्स है 97%. इफ योर इनकम इज बियॉन्ड अ पर्टिकुलर लिमिट the tax was as, I mean, those days for the rich people oppress you, that it was more than 90%. Now, aapka jo, there is no incentive for you to earn money beyond a particular point. So therefore, tax, in a socialist framework, a Nehruvian framework was, that we will not allow money to concentrate, we will not allow income. Agar income ek had, agar cross ho gaya, to aapka income will be taxed in such a manner that you have no incentive to earn more. I mean, this was the model on which we started. Up the budget went on changing. It went on shifting. Uska jo emphasis hai shift ho gaya. 1980s, first time when we have started borrowing money from the World Bank and you know when new economic policy, Rajiv Gandhi ke zamane mein jo hai ka budget ka shift start ho gaya. It is started, you know, its ka logic, its ka philosophy, its ka objective jo hai shift ho gaya. Ab 91, Furkhan sahab toh pata hai ki 1991 से जब ग्लोबलाइजेशन स्टार्ट हो गया, तो जब पूरा मकसद ग्लोबलाइजेशन का ये है कि आपका जो डेवलपमेंट है, अगर डेवलपमेंट ज़्यादा ग्रोथ रेट आपको बढ़ाना है, तो ग्रोथ रेट जब बढ़ेगा, जब जो है आपका कैपिटल जो है उसका थोड़ा फ्रीडम है, कैपिटल कैन एक्यूमुलेट. आपका कैपिटल एक्यूमुलेशन जो है बगैर, अब मैनेजमेंट थ्योरी में तो फुरखान साहब तो मैनेजमेंट थ्योरी मैनेजमेंट में तो हम ये पढ़ाते हैं कि एफिशिएंट मैनेजमेंट इज प्रोडक्टिविटी, इंक्रीजिंग द प्रोडक्शन. नाउ हाउ डू यू रेज द प्रोडक्शन? द न्यू लिबरल मॉडल, लिबरल मॉडल एंड न्यू लिबरल मॉडल प्री सपोज दैट सेल्फ इंटरेस्ट इज द ड्राइविंग फोर्स ऑफ द प्रोडक्टिव फोर्स. आदमी का जो सेल्फ इंटरेस्ट रहता है, आदमी जब ऐसा कोशिश करेगा, हार्ड वर्क करेगा, इनोवेशन आएगा, इकोनॉमी बदला जब आएगा, जब आदमी जो है बहुत हार्ड वर्क करते हैं, हार्ड वर्क आदमी ऐसा जब करते हैं जब उसका एक्यूमुलेशन का इंस्टिंक्ट जो है उसका थोड़ा हम मीट कर सके. सो सेल्फ इंटरेस्ट एज ए ड्राइविंग फोर्स ऑफ द इकोनॉमी. अब न्यू लिबरल मॉडल जो है वो सेल्फ इंटरेस्ट, जब एडम स्मिथ सेल्फ इंटरेस्ट यूज करा, थोड़ा उसका एनलाइटेंड सेल्फ इंटरेस्ट है, जरा दूसरे के बारे में थोड़ा सोचो वो है, बिकॉज एडम स्मिथ वॉज नॉट ओनली ए सपोर्ट, आई मीन ए फादर ऑफ द लिबरल थियरी, बट एडम स्मिथ was also wrote on ethics and morals. So there is an ethical concern of the economics, which Amartya Sen is supposed to have revived. So, jab agar aap ethical dimension pe dekhe, aur aapka jo equity iske baare mein soche, aap agar liberal model mein tho, thoda welfareism hai. Ab Keynes was one of those who said that no, welfareism is very important. But now the model has changed. The model has now changed, and now we are saying that you accumulate. And you give incentives to those who are accumulating in the market. Ab ye accumulation ka jab we think is a major impulse of economic development and self-interest is the driving force of the economic development, a budget jo hai, it can't be different from this basic assumption, the postulate on which we started from framing the budget. Ab isiliye jo budget mein aap ek bar ye jo social equity, distribution of income, ab budget mein kya ho sakta, agar bahut ameer log hai तो अमीर लोगों के पास से आप ज्यादा पैसे लेते हैं थ्रू टैक्सेशन, डायरेक्ट इनडायरेक्ट वॉट एवर. अब वो जो बजट में जो पैसे हैं तो वो गरीब के ऊपर आप स्पेंड करते हैं. दिस इज द एलोकेशन ऑफ द रिसोर्स दैट यू मोबिलाइज द रिसोर्स फ्रॉम द रिच एंड स्पेंड ऑन द पुअर, सो दैट यू मे नॉट ब्रिंग इक्वालिटी बट यू ब्रिंग सम कंसर्न ऑफ इक्विटी इन द इकोनॉमी. नाउ व्हाट हैज हैपेंड इन इंडियन इकोनॉमी फ्रॉम 91 टू 2009, इफ यू लुक एट द इकोनॉमी, 20 industrial houses command about 20 to 22% of GDP of the nation. 22% of GDP is controlled by the 20 industrial houses. 60 crores people get 18 to 20% of the GDP. 60 crore jo hai, 60 crores log jo hai, aadmi jo hai, aam aadmi jisko hum keh rahe, unka share jo hai, 100 rupaye mein 20 rupaye hai unka share. 18 se 20 rupaye. 20 industrial houses ka jo hai, 20 se 22 hai. This is the disparity. Now that is the reason why Ambani, as a birthday gift of his wife, he is giving 600 crores house. 600 crores ghar jo hai, wo birthday gift unke bibi ko de rahe. Aur hamare gaon agar aaye to gareeb musalman jo hai, aur gareeb dalit aadmi jo hai, usko khana milna mushkil hai. Ab how do you justify this disparity? अब हमारे पास एक राजगोपाल उनका जो अब तो आप देखे होंगे कि पार्लियामेंट में जो है 300 मेंबर्स ऑफ पार्लियामेंट उनका 5 करोड़ से ज्यादा आमदनी है 300 और लेस देन 1 करोड़ इन जो जो एसेट्स है उन लोगों का 0.44% रिप्रेजेंटेशन है पार्लियामेंट में. अब वो कैसा पार्लियामेंट होगा, वो पार्लियामेंट में कैसा बजट पास होगा? सोशल कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ पार्लियामेंट भी इंपॉर्टेंट होते ना, वो गरीब लोगों के बारे में. बट एक बात यह है कि फुरखान साहब जो बताए हैं इसमें एक है कि जब ग्रोथ रेट बढ़े, अब 9% जब ग्रोथ रेट हुआ या 8% ग्रोथ रेट हुआ, वेल्थ हैज गॉन अप. पूरा मुल्क में जो है वेल्थ हैज गॉन अप, दिस इज अ फैक्ट. जब व्हेन द वेल्थ हैज गॉन अप टू 9% इन 2004 द बजट, टोटल बजट ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ आंध्र प्रदेश, फुरखान साहब को पता है कि 3,40,000 करोड़ वॉज द बजट, सेंट्रल बजट. टूडे इट इज मोर देन 10 लाख करोड़. So from 3 lakhs crore, the total budget has become 10 lakhs crores. It's a major change. That's the reason why education got a major, you know, we got 38,000 crores. Ab UGC ka budget badh gaya. Ab UGC ka bhi hamara experience hai, ab 10-15 saal pehle agar aap ek meeting mein baithe, to joint secretary bolenge sahab, paise bahut kam hai. Thoda aap cut karna padega. Nahi, ek aadmi ko select kariye, ek project dijiye, do project dijiye. Ab UGC mein agar aap koi meeting mein, ab koi committee mein baithe, to paise ka problem nahi. Kitna bhi dijiye. Major research project, sab 10 lakh tak. Aap kitne bhi project bhi de sakte, paise ka sawal nahi, paise ka problem nahi. This UGC mein pura culture hi badal gaya. From the days of scarcity, when Professor Ram Reddy, my teacher, was UGC chairman, he used to say that I am sitting on the liquidation of the higher education of the country. But today, ab hum Professor Thorat saab bolte, paise ka bhi problem nahi, ki problem is people, no, institutions and all that. This has changed. This has changed because your growth rate has gone up. Because your budget has gone up, therefore you have given this money. Now, therefore, even the National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme, and now Mrs. Gandhi, she is very deeply interested in the Food Security Act, and the act is getting ready. Now, the already Planning Commission is debating, and it is very likely that Food Security Act will come this year or this parliament. That every person in this country will be assured of the food. Ab kaam kare ya nahi kare, it will be right to food. Now, right to employment, 100 days ka jo kaam de rahe, wo bhi uska thoda paise bada rahe. Now these two programs are very important. Even from a district that I come from, Mehboob Nagar, that's one of the most backward district. Hamara district se to 10 lakh se 12 lakh jo log jo hai migration chale jate hain. Bahut dur dur, Delhi, Punjab, kidhar bhi dekho desh mein, jo mulk mein jo hai, hamare palmur labor jo hard working hai, wo log rehte hain. Ab that migration has come down. It has come down. Sainath, in his article, has pointed out that it has come down. The buses which are going to Bombay, Ahmedabad, for taking my district labor, that has come down. Migrant and the khana jo hai, the gareeb aadmi ko thoda jada mil raha. This also fact, let's not accept that. I mean, let's not completely. It's true that the conditions of the poor people are slightly improving. Wages badh gaye, thoda servant maids Hyderabad mein thoda खाना ज़्यादा खा रहे, कंस्ट्रक्शन लेबर का कंडीशन थोड़ा इंप्रूव हो गया, तो सम इम्प्रूवमेंट इज देर. बट व्हाट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इज दैट व्हाइल रिलेटिव डिप्राइवेशन इज डिक्लाइनिंग, दैट द एब्सोल्यूट डिप्राइवेशन इज डिक्लाइनिंग, रिलेटिव डिप्राइवेशन इज गोइंग अप. दिस इज द मेजर यू नो प्रॉब्लम ऑफ द बजट. इन माई व्यू, वन ऑफ द मेजर प्रॉब्लम और मेजर चैलेंजेस ऑफ ए बजट इज दैट व्हाइल द एब्सोल्यूट डिप्राइवेशन इज गोइंग डाउन, relative deprivation is going up. अब हम जब जेएनयू में एक सिलेक्शन कमिटी में बैठे थे, वो जेएनयू वाइस चांसलर जो है वो इकोनॉमिस्ट है. तो एक बच्चे वो कैंडिडेट को पूछे कि देखिए एक आदमी का इनकम जो है उसका 10 times बढ़ गया, उसका 100 rupees आ रहे थे उसका 1000 rupees आ रहा है शुरू करा. एक आदमी का जो 10 rupees मिल रहा उसको 20 rupees हो गए. अब ये जो आदमी का जो 10 to 20 हो गया वो बेटर ऑफ हो गया या वर्स ऑफ हो गया, राइट? इज दिस नाउट जो गरीब आदमी जो 20 rupees मिल रहा मगर बाजू का जो अमीर आदमी का जो है वो 10,000 हो गया. अब इनका जो है बाइसिकल खरीद सकता है या नहीं पता नहीं मगर वो कार खरीद लिया. अब जब वो कार खरीदा वो कार पे नहीं था वो साइकिल था उसके पास, साइकिल वाले कार आ गए, इसको साइकिल पे आना मुश्किल है मगर खाना तो मिल रहा. उन्हें ये सोचेगा कि मेरा खाना तो मिल रहा है मगर हमारा बाजू का आदमी का जो है पूरा उसका जिंदगी बदल गया. Now, then that relative deprivation in a society has a social cost. Relative deprivation क्या होता है? अब जब deprivation, no, अब एक आदमी का जो income, अगर if Ambani's have 1 lakh crores, if he made in one lifetime, if I have not made, you know, any income, now my comparison is with somebody who has become absolutely rich. Now, how do you see? Then what is the way out? Now, I don't have much of time. I just want to leave one idea with you and stop. Now, I was in Sweden. Furkans are the whole Scandinavian countries, even today, they have retained the tax income from 60% to 80%, even today. American takes 40% of the income from the GDP. American budget, if you look at, they take at least 40% of the income from the total GDP. Scandinavian countries take from 60 to 80%. And in all Scandinavian countries, there is nothing like a private doctor, private hospital. There is nothing like a private school, private university, private college. And if you ask, you know, any Swedish citizen, are you paying fee? The students were asking me, what is fee? Fee means you have to pay something to university. They say, kyon? Why should we pay? It's your responsibility to the educators. Kyon bache fees pay karte? Because they don't have any concept of fee. The education is the responsibility of the society. So that the product of the higher education or whatever education, there is a moral claim of the society. Agar aap ek doctor ko banaye, wo doctor ko padhaye aap, aur uska pura dekhbhal kare, to doctor ke puch sakte, aap Adilabad jao, Srikakulam jao, nahi to Orissa ka backward area ko jao, bolke aap society can demand. Jab aap 60 lakh, 50 lakh laga ke aap agar education padhe, wo doctor ko Adilabad jao, to kyun jayega wo? Unhe bola ki main itna paise kharch kare, why should I go to Adilabad? Now, in other words, you see, manpower in a society should have a moral claim on the manpower. I mean, our present model, when you encourage privatization, which hamara Vaishnava sahab bata rahe the, bhai, ye education aisa, no, he was presenting the crisis of education. No, I'm not talking of health. I'm talking of health. No, you must see, because I myself was in a hospital. Must see the tension of the patient. Kitna budget aayega? अब हार्ट ऑपरेशन हो गया मगर बजट कितना आएगा वो तो हमारा आपका जो फाइनल जो कितना देगा बिल वो हार्ट प्रेशर बहुत ज़्यादा रहता है. योर हार्ट इज ऑल राइट यू नो बिकॉज टेक्निकली इट्स पॉसिबल बट फाइनेंशियली वी नॉट हैव दोज रिसोर्सेज. फॉर्चुनेटली नो ऑल 6 मेंबर्स ऑफ माय फैमिली आर एम्प्लॉयड, वी डिडंट हैव द टेंशन बट आई कुड सी द टेंशन ऑफ द नंबर ऑफ पीपल. नाउ व्हाई डू यू क्रिएट? नाउ व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज सपोजिंग इंडिया टेक्स 20% ऑफ जीडीपी इन द बजट. This is a Chanakya's Arthashastra, 1/6 of the, you know, you take, you know, the income from the total income of the rich people, right? Agar if you are taking only 1/6, only 20% of the income, if America is taking 40%, if Sweden is taking 60%, what is wrong with government of India if they take 30%? Now, if you raise it by another 10%, what is your budget? It will be 15 lakh crores. If it is 15 lakh crores, you spend 1 lakh crores on health. 1 lakh crores on education, you don't need to have this private university, this unity university, ICFA and all that. There is no need for the, but the argument has been that we don't have enough of resources. But you have to raise the resources from the collective and spend it on the larger collective good. And that's why Furkan sahab say, hamara ye hai ki, hamara position ye hai, ki budget should be not only a technical or techno-managerial instrument of responding to the exigencies of a time, but it should have a philosophy. And its job is to ensure social justice. And therefore, it has to be, the, and rich of the country should accept that if they do not share their wealth with the larger poverty-ridden people are poorer sections of the society, the fallout will be far more costlier. Social cost they have to pay, I mean, in terms of insecurity. Ab Hyderabad mein dekhiye, gated community, security. Now, this was not the case in 1950s and 60s. Insecurity, crime. The crime rate will go up. And, you know, then the movements, and then the struggles. Maybe armed struggle. A Maoist group is in 16, states of India, which has started, and when it was started, you know, it started in, West Bengal. I'm reading a book by the superintendent of police who was handling the Naxalbari movement. He said, he told the then government of West Bengal, he's a mosquito menace. When he was asked for an opinion, what does he think of the Naxalite movement? He said, it's a mosquito menace. From mosquito, now today, they are in the 16 states. And now they are saying this is the greatest security threat to India. Now, why is it spreading? We must ask the question, why is it spreading? Where is this unrest? Unless you address the question that, you know, either it will become a crime, prone society, or it will become a terrible, turmoil-ridden society. I think budget, if it does not address some of the serious problem and respond to the pressures and demands, I can share it and the press may not be there. In fact, when the cabinet formation was taking place, I have a friend and he was already included in the cabinet. Then I rang him up and said, why don't you accept MHRD? Because at least you have some respect for the universities. He said, the whole corporate world is sitting here. You think that there's no question. And he said that all fellows are here in Delhi now. They are very busy in getting a minister of their choice. See, this is how they work. Those who are economically powerful sit in Delhi, and the representatives of the poor people are missing. There's no lobby for poor man, and there is no moral pressure on the budget, and therefore budget does not respond. Still, because electoral politics are there, democracy is there, once in 5 years they have to go, this much of welfare has come. This at least no rural employment guarantees, and that's what won them the votes. Literally, Congress party is back because of NREGP. Not because the capital has grown 9% rate of growth. No. They have been voted back because this was a government which was concerned with some welfare. Earlier government neglected, and therefore they are there. And therefore welfareism, this is a mandate, as Furkhan saab, it is a mandate for welfareism. But aap ek bar aage to disinvestment bol rahe, foreign universities bol rahe, insurance reform bol rahe, banking reform bol rahe. Now, this was not a mandate. this was not a mandate for economic reform. This is a mandate for maybe reform with welfare, component. That is missing. That is missing. And I think this 5 years seem to be a government where maybe they will bring Food Security Act, but in my view, that it's not food security, it's not merely employment, but it's also certain dignity and certain equity. I think these also are the concerns of a budget, but if you do not have that concern and if you do not address, then the budget is responding to the demands of the time, not to the process of social transformation. We are not now having a vision of changing the society into a more egalitarian, humanitarian society, or a society which is participative, inclusive. I think Dr. Vijay will speak. No, we are not talking of that society. We are responding to the pressures, dominant economic interests, but we are not responding to the poorer and those sections of the society for centuries who had a deprivation, that dignity and that equity. If they are not the concerns, while budget may be a good, instrument and all that, but in the long run, what type of society you create also should be equally important. And as university people, we are interested in a long vision of the society, and we would like to look at budget from an egalitarian vision of the society and not from the, dominant pressure groups that operate at a given point of time. Thank you very much. I'm sorry I myself taken with that.